Hello, this is Cleantech Business TV for Solar Business Club, this time from Dubai, from Dubai Solar Show, but also from Vetex. And again, we are together with, you know, the most famous German person in Middle East, with Cornelius Matthes, Senior Vice President at DII and Chair of Solar Business Club here in the Middle East. Hello, Cornelius.
Thomas, hi. Great to be here with you.
So we are actually at the booth of Aqua Power, the founder, one of the founding members of DII initiative. So thank you so much, Paddy, for hosting us here. And Cornelius, I would like to ask you, because we are now preparing for Berlin, actually, yes, for the 10th anniversary summit of DII. Can you just very shortly tell us about the program, but also about, you know, who is coming, who are the speakers, and what you are expecting, you know, to get out of the event?
Well, thank you for this opportunity. It's an emotional moment because 10 years DII, that's really an important milestone for us. It was on 14th of July, actually, and the German press was quite full with articles looking back at when the famous DESERTEC was founded. So it is the 10th annual show. We had a long series starting in Barcelona in 2010, going to Cairo, to Morocco, to Berlin already one time, to Rome and Dubai the last few years. So it is the 10th summit to bring together the DII network, the shareholders, associate partners, but many of our friends. There will be, let's say, all key stakeholders from the MENA region at a high level. Just this morning, we had the confirmation from the chairman of Mazen in Morocco, Mr. Mustafa Bakouri. The minister, Mr. Rabah, will come as well. There will be the CEO of Nareva. We have from Algeria, the CEO of Sonelgas. The minister from Jordan, Halad Zawati, will come. And of course, Paddy, as the CEO of Aqua Power, will give one of the keynotes. But we have many more. This is just a small sample. And the DII platform is not a commercial conference. It is known for content. So we will present a DII publication on the storage working group. DII has other working groups. So this is kind
and
of
also round tables, yes?
Exactly. This is a thing DII has done over the last few years, interactive networking roundtables where people can get insights, thoughts, and have a very interactive discussion in a small group of 10, 15 people rather than just sitting in an audience and listening to a panel. And the feedback we got was quite good for this. So we are doing it again on the key topics. Green molecules, DESERTEC 3.0 is a big topic. You know, the next phase of DII, and we're doing a number of things in this field of green molecules.
So Cornelius, because you see, as I said at the beginning, that you are the most famous person in Middle East, but actually famous because you are a great expert, yes? Can you just tell us more, you know, what is now the situation in the Middle East? If you compare, you know, let's say the growth of solar market, but also other clean technologies in the Middle East comparing to last year. So what would be your major finding?
Well, the race to the bottom of the lowest prices is clearly continuing. The 1.69 cents for the Aqua Power bid for Diva Phase 5 is just a testament of this, which is great because it's a big accelerator of the market. And solar and renewables, also wind, close to 2 cents. So the benchmark is, let's say, 1.5 to 2.5 cents for solar and wind, whereas 2.5 is in the countries with a sub-investment grade rating. And this is very important because it's lower than conventional generation. So this has become a reality. It's an accelerator of the market by itself. And the big projects are all happening. 1.8 gigawatts of solar in Binban and Upper Egypt are now almost all connected. All these big projects, gigawatt scale, they're happening. And now new market segments are established, like net metering, industrial commercial rooftops, already big in Saudi. Shams Dubai will be close to 150 megawatt by year end. In Saudi, they're introducing a net billing regulation with a limited possibility to power wheeling as well. Egypt is coming. So new market segments are being formed, and new opportunities like for industrial heat, for different manufacturing or for enhanced oil recoveries is another interesting sector. Storage has a few tenders out, and storage itself also for off-grid. is an important field. Green molecules is a big topic, and DRI is doing a big study in this field because you can produce green hydrogen now at relatively low prices with a combination of solar and wind. So this all is Desertec 3.0. This all helps to make the power system emission-free. And there are many opportunities. Energy efficiency, maybe also to name in the region here, is a big growth field. And DI is active and has members in this field. So this is all about emission-free technologies and a holistic view on how to make the whole energy system emission-free.
You are also a member of Solar Business Club and you are chair for Middle East. And I would like to ask you, what is your feedback after this first year that we are really pushing the club, not only in the region, but also around the world?
Well, Solar Business Club has established, I think, itself with a great reputation. We've had in March here the gala in the Palazzo Versace with Akon and really amazing people, top advisors of heads of state here from different countries, from Africa attending. Solar Business Club is a small, invite-only, trusted organization, somehow comparable to DRI, and is really accommodating the leaders of the industry on a personal basis. So it's not a company, it's a personal basis. So people exchange.
Human to human.
Exactly. And business is done between people and not between companies. And I think this is what makes the concept very powerful.
That's why we can make so great partnership, yes?
Absolutely. We have many synergies. And the galas, and particularly the one in Munich around Intersolar, has been extremely well received. The level of people, I think this is quite unparalleled here in the industry. So I think this is what makes Solar Business Club powerful.
Thank you so much for the promotion of the club. Last question, Cornelius, practical. So if anybody from the international audience would like to join, you know, Berlin, so what they should do?
Well, the 10th annual summit of DRI this year, by the way, we have a very powerful partnership with GORFA, the German Arab Chamber, who are holding their 10th annual energy forum together with our forum. So it will be much bigger and very powerful.
And a very prestigious place, yes, in Adlon Hotel.
Well, it is in a number one place in Berlin, in Hotel Adlon, which is close to Brandenburg Gate. So it is, of course, first for the DI members, the associate partners, the GORFA members. But, of course, external people can register. We have a number of prominent speakers. Of course, you can just Google 10th Annual Summit of DI. You'll find immediately the webpage to register. There is a...
And also we'll put link below the video.
Yeah, exactly. We can do this. We can share the link. There's a small fee compared to commercial conferences, just to cover the costs to participate. And well, we'll have guests really even from China, from Geico, State Grid, U.S., the MENA region, Europe, from Brussels.
So actually, a global event, yes?
It's a global event, absolutely. And we are looking forward to welcoming a really interesting group, a very high level group of people, and discussing about the progress of DRI's work, the working groups, and the partnerships, and what to do in the next years of DRI.
Okay, so we can finish, Cornelius, our interview with thumbs up for Paul Vanson, the guy who was, you know, creator of the DII initiative 10 years ago. And you see, like, since 10 years, the initiative is very successful and is entering in now in the DII 3.0. Yes,
Ira? Desertec 3.0, and Paul indeed is the president and CEO of DII. And DII has grown significantly. We have a team of almost 15 now in different locations, Dubai based, but London, Madrid, Germany. And we have really a powerful organization, and well, I think under Paul's leadership, and Paul will, by the way, be almost fully available for DRI from next year, as he's leaving his position in energy. So that's other great news. So we can do even much more, and with a double associate partner group with prominent new companies joining recently, such as Neom from Saudi Arabia, Saipem from Italy, Ecolog or Mazda here from the UAE, or Yellow Door, Innerware, Enverfina. It's all great names, and we are working together really towards our mission, which is no emissions.
And Solar Business Club will be there. So thumbs up for Paul, for Cornelius, for the team, and for the 10th anniversary of DII. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, Thomas. Wonderful.